So now our limits will become I equal to, first we will write for region R1 plus region R2, which will be complete region R. Okay, so first here we write the limits of region R1. So in R1, x is going from 0 to 4. So x is going from 0 to 4. Then integration y is going from 0 to y equal to x. Y equal to x, then this term, that is x square dy dx. So this is the limit for this region. Till here we have line, then we have curve. So this is the separate region R2. Here x is going from this point to this point. So here we have x equal to 4. So lower limit will be x equal to 4 and the upper limit will be here, x equal to 8. Then what is the limit of y? Limit of y is for this strip, because we are considering region R2. In region R2 we have curve in our equation. So y is going from 0 to this point. At this point y is 16 by x, which is hyperbola. So y is 16 by x, and this same term we again write here. So now if you see, this is the new integration which we have to perform in region R1 and in region R2. So as we have decided, first we will integrate with respect to y, and then we will integrate with respect to x. So this x square is constant, so we can take it here. So we get integration of x equal to 0 to x equal to 4 x square, and here we do not have any y term, so it is an integration of dy. What is integration of dy? Integration of dy is nothing but y, and then we apply the limit, that is y equal to 0 to y equal to x, and this dx will remain as it is. Plus here also, first we are integrating with y, so x will remain constant, so we can take this x square here. So we get integration of x equal to 4 to 8 x square, and here also we do not have any y term, so what is integration of dy? Integration of dy is nothing but y, and here we write the lower limit, and here we write the upper limit, and this dx will remain as it is. So here we have upper limit minus lower limit for this term. So when we put y equal to x, here we get x. When we put y equal to 0, here we get 0 dx, and this integration will remain as it is, plus this term will remain as it is, that is x is going from 4 to 8 x square. Here we write the upper limit minus the lower limit for this term. So when we put y equal to 16 by x, we get 16 by x. When we put y equal to 0, here we get 0 into dx. So this term is x minus 0, so this term is nothing but x, and x into x square will be nothing but x cube, and this integration plus 16 by x minus 0, this term is nothing but 16 by x, and here we have x square. So x square into 16 by x is nothing but 16x. So this whole term is nothing but 16x, and integration of x equal to 4 to x equal to 8 dx. Now if we perform this integration, what is integration of x cube? Integration of x cube is nothing but x raised to 4 upon 4, and here we put the lower limit and the upper limit. Okay, similarly 16 is constant, so it can be taken out of the integration sign, and integration of x is nothing but x square upon 2. So here we put the lower limit and the upper limit. So 1 upon 4 we will remain as it is into, put x equal to 4 here, it will be 4 raised to 4 minus x equal to 0 plus this 16 into, when we put x equal to 8 here, so it will be 8 square minus x equal to 4. When we put x equal to 4 here, it will be 4 square. Here we have 2 also, so divided by 2. So this equation will now become this. So now if you see here, we have 1 upon 4, 4 raised to 4 minus 0 is nothing but 4 raised to 4 plus 2 ones are 2, 2 8 just 16, 8 into 8 square minus 4 square is nothing but 64 minus 16. So 1 4 from here will get cancelled, so we get 4 cube, which is nothing but 64 plus 8. 64 minus 16 is nothing but 48, 48 into 8 is nothing but 384. So 384 plus 64 is nothing but 448. So this is our final answer of this question, and this is how we solve the type 2a problems on multiple integration. More such problems we will see in our next video, so stay tuned for our future lectures.